exception of the Dow University of Health Sciences, the alumni of the college, of the Dow Medical College, had been requesting that their children should be admitted to the university and a way should be found around it. And the way was the inception of the Dow International Medical College in 2007, which was started off initially in a smaller building, but then moved to a 200,000 square foot facility within the OJA campus. This initially admitted 100 students annually, and subsequently, with increasing demand and the permission of the PMDC, this was increased to 150 students annually. The college, the Dow International Medical College, is recognized by the U.S. residency certification, and in addition is included in the WHO list. It is recognized by the CPSP, the PMC, as well as the Higher Education Commission for awarding MBBS degrees. The college has excellent facilities both for teaching and for research, and also on the campus there are very nice residential facilities which allow students, especially those who are from the United States and Europe, to live here. All in all, the college has been progressing and has been improving on its performance, and the students have been passing out with good scores and achieving good scores in the USMLE. Thank you very much.
Welcome to the Dow International Medical College, DIMC. It was established in 2007 under the aegis of the Dow University of Health Sciences, DUHS, with the primary objective of facilitating the children of non-resident Pakistanis who face immense difficulties in entering the medical profession abroad, especially because of the high costs involved and a total period of 8 years in the USA against a 5-year course of MBBS in Pakistan.
In the United States, obviously, it's extremely expensive to for your tuition, for your education in medical sciences. And in Pakistan, is in Dow International Medical College, it's fairly cheaper related to the United States education.
The reason why I chose DIMC is because the course of study was a lot less stressful than back home. And also, like, price-wise, it was a lot easier. I didn't want to do, like, loans or anything, so it was easier on my parents to send me here.
The students come mainly from the USA, while Canada, UK, Australia, and the Middle East are also well represented. Its inclusion in the International Medical Education Directory signifies that the college has been recognized internationally. Please check out the listed links. In 2009, DIMC shifted from its temporary accommodation to a specially designed building and the latest comprehensively fitted state-of-the-art equipments. 5 air-conditioned lecture halls, each with a seating capacity of 300, with multimedia and other advanced audiovisual facilities, and 10 seminar cum tutorial rooms catered to student needs. DIMC possesses top-of-the-line laboratories and museums for each basic sciences department, including anatomy, physiology, biochemistry, pharmacology, forensic medicine, community medicine, and pathology. The anatomy department also has its own bone bank, where 25 fiberglass replica skeletons are available, and a plastic body museum for study of body viscera. There is also a purpose-built dissection hall with cold storage facilities for cadavers. These facilities are all fully air-conditioned, and powerful generators provide electricity round the clock. The biochemistry department has full facilities with provision for all necessary experiments to be carried out, with safety measures focused on the chemicals used in the laboratory. The pathology department has all sections including histopathology, microbiology, chemical pathology and hematology, backed up by an on-site diagnostic laboratory which provides complete facilities to patients of the Dow University Hospital and other healthcare facilities. The dental section of the Dow International Medical College has been established in 2012 to offer BDS courses to overseas students. It has been recognized by the Pakistan Medical and Dental Council, PM&DC, to admit 50 dental students. It has state-of-the-art lecture halls and seminar rooms, an air-conditioned OPD equipped with sophisticated dental units, a digital library with access to online journals, well-equipped basic medical and dental sciences laboratories, and a prosthetic and ceramic laboratory. It has multidisciplinary programs for dental research, a major strength of any dental school. An integrated curriculum of international standard is being followed. The dental hospital attached to this section provides all types of dental treatment at very low rates, almost on a cost-to-cost basis. At other equivalent facilities, this type of treatment is extremely expensive. About 200 patients avail these facilities daily. All types of treatment are provided by a well-trained team of dental consultants. This includes simple to complex treatments ranging from simple scaling, root planing, deep curettage, rotary endodontics, implants, prosthesis, maxillofacial trauma management, panfacial trauma management, and facial rehabilitation to induced stem cell regeneration of pulp in open apices. Sterilization of all required instruments is maintained as per international protocol, the patient's well-being being the top priority. The faculty and staff of the dental section are also involved in community dentistry programs and research activities. A fully functional Dow diagnostic and radiology complex equipped with ultrasound, mammography, echocardiography, Doppler, fibroscan, CT scan and MRI scan allows students to observe interventional procedures.
My parents and I chose DIMC because over here the facilities are very nice, and also because the system over here is improved and it's much faster, and you can come here at a much lower cost.
Clinical departments include general medicine, psychiatry, dermatology, endocrinology, infectious diseases, gastroenterology, cardiology, pediatrics, and neonatology, gynecology and obstetrics, ophthalmology, and otolaryngology, as well as general, orthopedic, and plastic surgery. All these departments are staffed by dedicated, highly qualified teaching faculty with fellowships in their relevant fields and headed in most cases by professors who have PhDs.
Faculty is very professional, very well trained. We have professors who are PhDs. A lot of our assistant professors are PhD students. They're all very highly qualified. The lectures take place all in English with state-of-the-art equipment. They have projectors. Pretty much anything you'd expect at a university back home.
When you do comparison between US and Pakistan, especially when I look at DIMC, standard of education is amazing here. The teachers are brilliant, they're really caring, and they want to teach you. They genuinely care about you becoming a good doctor.
An on-site 350 workstation-based digital library, which is connected with the PERN site of the Higher Education Commission, provides students and faculty access to about 17,000 journals through the internet. A well-stocked library in the same building also offers excellent study and research facilities. The practicals have also been shifted from the conventional viva system to a structured objective practical or clinical examination, OSPE and OSCE. Faculty members of every department are involved in curriculum development, leading to an improved integration process. New structured viva, clinical exam and examination systems guarantee a fairer assessment of a student's performance, as it is now based on MCQs and OSCEs.
The teaching standard is far than exceptional. All the lectures over here are in English, so it's easy to understand, easy to process and comprehend. It's just like America.
Hands-on practical training is also given to students through various workshops, including in primary trauma care, basic and advanced cardiac life support, and other specialized skills. Clinical training is provided in the Dow University and Oja hospitals, where students have an opportunity to observe and learn from senior physicians and consultants. A unique feature at the DIMC is Pakistan's first mentor program. Its primary purpose is to assist students from abroad to get successfully acclimatized. Each participating faculty member is assigned a group of 10 to 15 students whom he or she counsels in matters ranging from academic performance to any social or personal adjustment problems they may face.
Hi, my name is Severa Narajra. I just completed my second year at Dalhousie National Medical College. These past 2 years have been amazing. What I love about Dalhousie is that you can complete your medical education here in just 5 years instead of 8 years like in the U.S. My favorite spot on campus is at the library. It's my favorite place to go to. The teachers here are amazing. They're very friendly and helpful. It's great to interact with students from all over the world, and you will not regret coming here at all.
Raj Fatma, and I'm a final year medical student at Dow International Medical College and also an overseas student from Canada. The education here at DIMC is customized, meaning that the teachers, the way of teaching, the syllabus, the curriculum, and the environment, it all facilitates an overseas student to be adjusted here. Here we have clinical exposure to different fields of medicine like internal medicine, family medicine, surgery, gynae, obstetrics, and pediatrics. Life at the campus is never boring. Throughout the year, we have many paracurricular activities like DIPCA, which is Dow Patient Care Association, and annual Dow Olympics, Youth and Navy conferences, and several other competitions. Personally, I've had an amazing 5 years learning patient care from our great professors and scrubbing in surgeries. I think that training here makes the students at par with international standards, and I think that we can work and compete in any part of the world.
Great importance is also given to physical fitness. A state-of-the-art gymnasium and sports complex with a covered area of almost 15,000 square feet provides co-curricular activities to both students and faculty members. It possesses excellent facilities for basketball, table tennis, badminton, and other indoor and outdoor games. Besides a huge hall, there are two spectator galleries and a waiting area, as well as toilets and locker rooms, kitchen, dining room, store, and a therapy room. There is also a turf-rolled cricket pitch and a football field. And apart from a well-frequented canteen, there are separate purpose-built hostel blocks on campus for both girls and boys, with each room an attached bathroom planned for double occupancy. The hostels have spacious dining rooms as well as study-cum-reading rooms, common rooms, and prayer rooms. The mess facility is mandatory for hostel residents, based on the assumption that the food cooked in its large hygienic kitchens is safer than outside food for those not yet acclimatized to local conditions. Special permission to dine off campus may be granted and charged transport is provided if desired. The strict security in place in the hostels is based on current realities and is regularly monitored to ensure the safety of its occupants. Outdoor messengers are provided for purchase of any items from off-campus.
The security provided in the hostel is actually very good. I'm surprised because outside the campus it's not really safe, but when we're inside the hostel, within the campus area, I feel secure, and the security guards are doing a really good job. the lady guard that's inside the hostel. She always makes sure that we're inside, and we have a curfew, which is 8 p.m.
Security is given top priority at DIMC. A computerized login system using special software monitors students' entry and faculty and staff attendance. Security guards and cameras are employed to ensure a risk-free environment, and only authorized visitors are admitted.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm Professor Zarnaz Wahid and the principal of Dow International Medical College. And I'm very proud to be the principal here because it gives me an opportunity to meet my fellow colleagues also and friends from abroad. And this is, of course, a college which was made initially with the idea to promote admissions of children of overseas Pakistanis, because they face a lot of difficulty entering into the medical system there. And fortunately, most of the Dow alumni have taken to our medical college, and I feel so proud that I'm also a Dow alumni. So here you can see we have had almost 9 batches who have passed out, and over almost 150 students have passed the USMLE and they are doing the residency. So looking into the figures, at the moment we have over 700 students here, and we feel very proud of them, and most of them are very happy with us, and we have all the facilities as you can see, and our visionary vice chancellor is patronizing our projects, and he really takes keen interest in our medical college. And you all know Professor Saeed Qureshi, and he is not only looking into everything, but he has built up our faculty, who is very, very dedicated, and who really looks after the children. And we as a team at Dow, the principal office, the vice principal, we are so interlinked with the children that it's like a family. And I welcome you all to send your children here and to enjoy the facilities that we offer. Thank you.
Program information, admission details, and application forms for prospective students are all available on DIMC's website. For any queries, please contact at the given email address.